it will help absolutely if the local, your local government or the, and the transportation agencies apply for the funding, which I'm sure they're going to keep the system running and to really expand them. Because, you know, this infrastructure spending stimulates the economy. It creates good jobs that are paid well. It builds bridges, roads, and it makes our community more productive. And with transit, we get people out of their cars, and it helps our environment, and it works all the way around. You know, one thing you need to know is that for every $1 billion we spend on infrastructure, we create 40,000 jobs. So, somebody asked me earlier, were we going to really create jobs? Well, we're talking about $800 billion program, so that's a lot more than 40,000 jobs. For every $1 billion, 40,000. And we do have huge transportation issues. Highway 101, we have to get smart rail up and going, and we need to keep our existing transit systems so that they can be efficient and productive. So I think that's what we're talking about.
And I know there are quite a few people, at least here in the cell, that they're actually dependent on the system. More routes cut makes it even harder.
Well, it makes it, when transit becomes hard to schedule, then people find other ways to get places, and then we lose all the way around. You need to get people out of their cars. And people who don't have to have cars have to have other ways to get around.
Exactly.
Yes. So thank you.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
If you just joined our call, if you have a question for Congresswoman Lloyd Wolfe this evening, please press star 3 on your phone chat and give your name and question to one of our town hall operators. Congresswoman, we're going now to Hank from Petaluma, who'd like to talk to you about TARP and executive pay. Hank?
Hello, thank you.
Taxes so that it comes back and helps them. when we voted on the HARP 1, that was H.R. 384, the initial HARP Reform and Accountability Act, there wasn't a lot of transparency and accountability added into it. And we have to ensure that the next go-around that we do a better job.
Yes, I appreciate that. But is the Progressive Caucus going to be doing anything about executive compensation?
Oh, absolutely. Our goal, we will be speaking out that we absolutely support limiting executive compensation for the organizations that are relying on taxpayer funds to keep their bank or their financial institution going, and we're not going to sit still for super lavish Super Bowl parties and corporate jets and huge salaries while they're laying off hundreds of people, the CEOs are, getting all of this. It's just unbelievable to me that they would use their funding that way. Now, know that every single bank that's getting TARP funds is not doing that, but those who are need to be stopped. And the Progressive Caucus will be working on that.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Hank. And this leads me to our next poll question. Because there's been a lot of talk about capping the salaries of CEOs and banks who are receiving taxpayer money and capping the amount at $500,000, do you support such limits? If you support these limits, press 1. If you oppose them, press 2. And if you don't have any opinion, press 3. So there we go again. The question is, do you support limits on using taxpayers' money for CEOs of banks, which would limit their pay to $500,000 a year? Press 1, do you support these limits? 2, if you oppose them? 3, if you don't have an opinion on it. And we'll get back to you and tell you
the
results.
And thank you, Congresswoman. If you're just joining the call, please press